Good morning everyone and welcome to today's market commentary. So we can see that market is very much volatile today. It opened at 10,263 and the low made was 10,074, and again it is trading at 10,334 now. Now these 10,330 levels are very important to us, because earlier this was the high made, there was a Mariposa here, and the same level was support at this zone. Again it was a resistance here, resistance, support, resistance, resistance again, and here it acted as a support. Now this this level should act as a resistance even now for bearishness to continue in Nifty. Any close above that should bring out a new rally in Nifty, so it is very important to watch out the levels here. Now the fall which we saw today, this was clearly visible on the hourly chart. So before going to hourly chart, one thing what I want to bring to your notice here is the lowest low which was made today, that was a very important level for Nifty. Earlier it acted as a resistance, and even here also the big red candle, here it acted as a resistance. Even here also, and to go above this resistance, it had to open gap up. Again, that was the low made here, and here also it acted as a resistance. There was a price rejection, and so today also it found a good support level at the very same level, around 10,090 to 10,070 levels. So as told earlier, on the upper hand, 10,333, which was the close of this candle, the very important level. So any point, 20 points upside and 20 points downside, there can be a little difference. We can give a buffer of 20 points on either side, but however, that 10,333 is a very important level. Now on so on 4 hours chart, divergence was seen. Price made a higher high and indicator made a lower high. This was seen on 15th December morning session only, the first 4 hour candle. And this was seen near the monthly R1 of pivot points. So that was our second confirmation here, and that was also a doji candle. After a gap up, we had a doji candle. So we had three confirmations here of bearishness that was going to come in the future. I'm going to 1 hour chart. So even here, there was a clear bearish divergence. So in the first 1 hour itself, it was very clear that bearishness was going to come in Nifty. So we saw that in the earlier session itself. So around 300 points of fall was there. If you see from the second candle onwards, from 15th December to today's opening session, around 300 points of fall was seen after this bearish divergence was witnessed. Now this zone is also a gap zone here. There was a gap down earlier, and going forward it acted as a resistance. Now again on 15th December there was a gap up opening, and this gap it got filled here, and the bearishness continued. So divergences play a very important role in the market. So even if it is a volatile day or less volatile day, so some sort of future movements you can get to know using these divergences at the very important levels. So here at the R1 itself, again the same story has happened: gap and divergence and monthly R1. So these three things have confirmed us for the future bearishness in Nifty. Now again on the upper side, 10,333 is an important level, and on the hourly time frame, this 10,374, the high of this candle, can be a good resistance. On early time frame, one more thing what we saw was so this was a trend line resistance here. So connecting the high of this candle with the high of this candle and going forward, there was a strong red candle at the same zone. So even here also there was a support for this trend line, and on 15th December the same candle acted as a resistance. Now on daily time frame, let us mark this level, the high of this candle, 10,309. So on daily time frame, this is the resistance zone for Nifty, and here it is very clear that 10,493 should be the strongest resistance on the upper side, because that is the lifetime high of Nifty. So keep an eye on the bearish divergences on daily time frame also. If price is making a higher high, just look at the prior highs of RSA also. So that might be giving you a clue even now. So just mark straight line from the earlier high and see if price is making a higher high or is it closing above this level, and then again observe the divergences in RSI also. So let us see what happens by the end of the day, today's session. So in Bank Nifty, the channel which we drew, that acted as a good support, and the low made today was exactly the S2 of this month. On upper hand, it is 25,700, the resistance for Bank Nifty, very important resistance. Any close above this should take it to the earlier high made. Let me clear all these small lines here. So yes, on the upper side, Bank Nifty has this 25,700 to be precise, the resistance on the upside, and any close above that should take Bank Nifty to 25,945, which was the earlier high made. So that should act as a strong resistance for Bank Nifty on the upper side. So the election results are still going on. So this is the majority now. and the source is directly from Election Commission of India. So BJP is leading or winning in 94 seats and Congress in 64. So by the end of the day, we can get a clear picture like where it is heading to. So even on early time frame also the story is same. This zone, this congestion zone is very important resistance level for Bank Nifty. So any close above 25,700 should take that to 25,945 or so. And this week the R2 is in confluence with 25,960 and 943 levels. So this zone should act as a strong resistance for Bank Nifty on the upper hand. So we are seeing bearish divergence on 15 minute time frame. So this 25,696 or 25,700 should act as a good resistance for Bank Nifty in intraday, because there we can see a strong bearish divergence being formed. So from there we can expect Bank Nifty to take a U-turn, or at least until this level around 769 or 770. Even in Nifty, there is a bearish divergence. So around this 10,409, there should be a U-turn possible for Nifty also. So bearish divergence in Nifty and Bank Nifty. So for Nifty, there can be a U-turn, possible U-turn at this 10,409 levels. And for a Bank Nifty, there can be a bearish divergence at 25,700. These are the two important levels for Nifty and Bank Nifty. Clear bearish divergence is seen in intraday chart of 15 minutes. So this is the story of Nifty and Bank Nifty. There is a bullish divergence in BEML. Price made a lower low. And RSI made a higher low. This happened at the S2 of monthly pivot points. And the same zone is also a strong support zone here earlier. So three things are confirming to us. One is the bullish divergence in RSI. Second, the same thing happening at monthly S2. And third, that was a natural support zone earlier also. So So now to determine when to enter the trade, I'll take the help of Fibonacci retracement here. So observing from here, either this should be your first low or this should be your low. So let us evaluate both the conditions. From this low, I'm marking this high. So price is trading at 0.382 level, which is 1500. So it can, on weekly time frame, if it takes a U-turn here, then a good move can be seen until 1672 on weekly time frame. Now the same thing, the high remains the same, but I'm shifting the low from here to here. So from this low, I have marked until this high. So price, and in this setup, price bounced back. Today's low exactly was 0.618, which is 1440. Now, if there is a close above 1538 in this setup, we can see price going to 1635 and then to 1756 based on this setup. So based on these levels, currently it is trading at 1516.95. So based on this setup, BEML is bullish above 1538, and on first hand it can reach 1635, and a close above this can take that to this gap zone. So on daily time frame, this was a very important zone. So this is the zone I was talking about. Good amount of support earlier going forward that acted as a resistance. So even now also, this is the central pivot point of this month. So any close above this 1538 will bring BEML to 1635. And then going forward, this will act as a strong resistance to BEML. So there was a bullish divergence on daily time frame, and we are bullish on BEML if there is a close above 1538. So Coal India, this zone earlier it was a resistance zone, and even here also it acted as resistance for at least two sessions. Now going forward, this has become a support zone. Now this natural support zone is in confluence with monthly S1. Again, that was a 0.5 retracement on Fibonacci. So I took the Fibonacci retracement on weekly time frame from the lowest low made to the highest high made. So it is showing me that this zone is also yearly S1. See here, this yearly S1, exactly price took a U-turn from there, and that was also Fibonacci 0.5 retracement. Now today it is trying to close above this 0.382, which is 271. So any close above 271 should take Coal India to 280. And if this gap gets filled, now we can expect Coal India to reach at least until 295. So the observations, again, I'm repeating it. So on weekly time frame, we'll be seeing yearly pivots. So these pivots are same throughout the year, which is 2017 to 2018 January. So price, it took a rejection from S1 of this year, and this 20 period moving average was also in confluence here. And this was the earlier resistance zone on weekly time frame that going forward, it has become a support zone. So three to four things are in confluence on weekly time frame. And on daily time frame, there is also a bullish divergence here. So after this bullish divergence on 15th December, there was a good up rally and the price closed above this 20 period moving average. Now it is trying to go higher. So the close above this 271 should take Coal India to at least the central pivot point, which is 278. And on the upper hand, this 0.236 will act as a resistance, which is 280. Now this 280 is in between this gap zone. So if this gap zone get filled, there can be a reversal or continuation of this earlier rally. So 283 is a deciding level for Coal India. It can either take a reversal or it can go to the upper side until 295. So this was the observation on Coal India. This was a very important zone for Bharti Infratel. The upper line acted as a resistance and lower line acted as a support. So this complete channel was a congestion zone or a support zone for Bharti Infratel. And price closed below that. Now again it has come to a very important level, which is monthly S1. So on 15th December, the low made was monthly S1. Here it is. And there was also a slight bullish divergence on daily time frame. Now the same zone, it is 0.618 Fibonacci retracement, again going down to weekly time frame. And marking this Fibonacci retracement from the lowest low made to the highest high. So that the current zone, it is 0.618 Fibonacci level. So a close above this 358 should bring a bullish rally in Bharti Infratel. But on the upper side, this channel is acting as a strong resistance. So going forward, close above this 358 should first bring it down to 365. Then 375 and finally to 382. So for the bearishness, for the bullishness to continue, we'll be needing a close above this 382 in future. So we have marked this Fibonacci retracement on weekly time frame. So now price is trying to close above this 0.618 level, which is 358. So as seen here, this 358 is also the central pivot point of this whole year. So since we are on weekly time frame, we'll be having a single central pivot point for the whole year. So price is trying to close above this central pivot point also. If it manages to close above 360 per se, so 360 is a very important level for Infratel now. Close above this 360 makes it closing above this 0.618 at the same time this central pivot point. So that should bring in at least some amount of bullishness in Infratel on weekly time frame. And on daily time frame also, slight bullish divergence was seen here in RSI. So there was a higher high, higher low made here, and here it was then lower low. So we can expect bullishness coming in Bharti Infratel on daily time frame also. Now this bullish divergence was very much clear in hourly time frame. So price made a lower low here. And RSI made a higher low. So this is a very clear bullish divergence in Bharti Infratel on hourly time frame. So symmetric triangle is in the process of forming in this Exide industry stock, and price is now trading at 20 period moving average and central pivot point. So a break on the upper side, that two above, there should be a close above this 207 for this symmetric triangle to come into play. And if it manages to close above this 207, 208, so it can go until 215. So this 215 is the monthly R1, and at the same time it was the prior resistance twice. There was a gap down opening, and the high of these two candles, the low of these all candles, and high of this red candle here. So it all shows us that 215 on the upper side could act as a strong resistance for Exide Industries. And now this for this setup to come into play, there should be a close above 208 for Exide Industries. The reason for 208 is that 208 price level acted as resistance thrice in these three sessions. And again, the high and opening of this red candle, it was around 208. And again, the high of this green candle, that was also around 208. So even if this, even if there is a close above the central pivot point and 20 period moving average, and even if it breaks symmetric triangle on the upper side, definitely there should be a close above this 208 for bullishness to continue in Exide Industries. So wherever you see there is a clear bullish divergence which is seen in Exide Industries, price is making a lower low, and RSI is either at the same zone or it is going higher. So these are the stocks and indices which I have chosen for today's market commentary. Thank you all. Thank you for joining.